Already. We're gonna fly ourselves some PC-12 legs here. At least one. Maybe more. Chase that FS Economy virtual dollar. Gonna chase that 200th follower. Should be fun. Let's see. So to first rig I'm gonna think I'm gonna do is Reno up to Portland. Yes, this is a serious microphone for serious business streamers. Yeah, it's new. I got tired of the way the headset sounded. Just didn't sound very good. My voice isn't a great broadcasting voice to begin with, and the headset wasn't helping, so we got the real deal. Oh yeah, dude. The Piaggio, the Avanti. Yeah, she's a looker. Go have a look right now. Say. So yeah, we're over here in Reno, Nevada, the new Pilot Edge bonus field for the western area for the next couple weeks. We're on the terminal's over here, so we're on the east side of the field. We are on the network right now. We got the claps. Whiskey Charlie, thank you very much for the host. Appreciate that. So this should be fairly straightforward. Route-wise, I think I'm going to steal what the pros use. This is a Verizon flight, the Dash 8, and we're a PC-12, but the route should be pretty much the same. So we're going to try Mustang 8 departure, Mustang transition, Juliet 92, Klamath Falls, Moxie, Portal, and the Timbers 2 arrival into Portland. That should be about an hour and a half, maybe closer to hour and 45 minutes when all is said and done. Should be a good time. Let me go ahead and power. Avionics. Yeah, a little bit of weather to fly through on the way there. Shouldn't be too bad. For altitude, I think we're going to do about 22,000. I think that should be about right. To get us high enough to be over some of the more serious stuff while not pushing the limits of this thing too much. It is pressurized, so it can go, I think, up to 300, 30,000, something like that. Anyway, we don't want to push it too much. So nav lights on. All right, we got avionics. I do need to file. I have not filed yet. So Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo. Where are we? We have GPS. Yeah. And a transponder. We are not RVS. I suspect we'll true out around 250-ish. Reno to Portland. 2000 for now. Alternate. Well, that's a good question. Redmond would work. Redmond, RDM. All right, route wise, Mustang 8, Mustang 8. I'll flight SciTech. Thank you very much, sir. Appreciate that. There it is. 92, Klamath Falls. Little. Jim Rules, thank you for the host. Appreciate that. See, that's what it was. All right. Don't know if we'll get this route from clearance, but we'll get a shot. All right, we are already connected. Go grab the clearance frequency here. Busy.tv, thank you for the follow. I think you're 199 on the follower count. Very nice. Appreciate that. Mr. Kirk's in the house. Good to see you. Mr. Clocky in the house. Good to see you as well. Hope you gentlemen are doing well. We're just getting started. You haven't missed a thing. Yeah, Jazz. You gotta get the real thing up here, man. Get the all-white everything paint. Jazz N is a owner of a real plane, and it has the most striking all-white paint job. It's a looker. Yeah, this PC-12, just got it a couple days ago. I like it so far. Only flown it a tiny bit, so. Right, should be tuned up here. Take one quick peek. Map. Yep, we're on freak. Somewhat surprised I'm not hearing anything. Maybe it's just quiet.
San Francisco Tower, Mirror 1263, coming at one left with Tango.
Wait. All right, I'm going to turn that
off. 1263, San Francisco Tower, one left.
Bit. Oh, we got the boss on tonight. Peter's working.
One left, clear to go, Mirror 1263.
Love it. Mile High FSX. Thank you, sir. Hello. Thank you for watching. Welcome. Notes here so I don't forget what we're doing. Reno delivery, good evening. Pilatus 1, Victor Kilo for clearance to Portland.
Pilatus 1, Victor Kilo, Reno clearance. Clearance on request, standby.
IAS mode works well. On the PC-12? Interesting. I haven't tried that yet. Is that like a level change mode that just holds the speed up to and down to certain altitudes? That's what I would guess, but... Whilst we wait for clearance here. Our altimeter. All the pressure in the pilot edge area has been super high lately. At clearance. Right on speed hold, yeah, that's what I guess. Good question, are my arrivals as exciting as kills? Well, this plane, I haven't flown a ton, so I've been plopping it down pretty good for, you would think for something that flies an approach at 90 knots, I could figure it out, but.
Well, American 386 contact has, Seattle Center, 121.4.
More challenging than I might have expected so far. We're flying a lot of airliners, and those are
American 1263
easier
contact
to fly. I kind of went from Bonanzas to
NorCal 1263
737s, and now we're back on a plane that requires a little more skill, and it's requiring some
American 386
skill,
heavy Seattle Center climb attainment altitude 30.
That's all right. The nice thing is when I do it on the stream, I got the video of it, and I can go back and watch and see all the things I did wrong. That's why I like to do that. Whilst we're waiting, I'm going to program in
number one, Victor Kilo.
That's us.
Reno clearance, go to the Portland Airport, Mustang 8, departure, Mustang VOR, then it's filed, climb via SID, departure frequency 119.2, squawk 5551.
Okay, cleared Mustang 8, Mustang, climb via SID, 119.2, 5551 for 1 Victor Kilo.
1 Victor Kilo, read back act.
Alright, so we got our route that we wanted. I'll show you this departure. Pretty simple. We just come off of the
1-6 roger,
following this back
Seattle
course
Center, 1,
3, to 3DME 5. On the back course. And then after that, turn left direct to Mustang and hold there to climb. Hopefully we don't have to do too much holding for this one. So I'm going to put the back course in the
American
primary.
American 1263. NorCal departure, radar contact, climb and takeoff 190.
Here, I guess. Yeah, down there it works. We'll put 117.
American 386, Seattle Center, climb maintain level 350.
Go. All right. Keep that handy. One sec. Jimmy Buffett's PC-12 at your little airport in Mass. That's awesome, man. That's super cool. Right. So we're actually right next to the tower. Could show you where that is. So we're just right on this little ramp here. Turn the view so we're in direction here. This right here is Charlie. 16 left, 16 right. So we'll probably go off 16 left, I'm imagining. Forming in town, that's cool. Cool. South course we want to track is 164. We can program that now. We're waiting. I'm going to try the PC-12 on XP-11. I have not. Not much for trying explain betas. I will mess around with them and see how they look, but I don't put any add-ons into them or try to do any actual flying, and certainly not streaming with beta software. I'm a developer myself. I know what beta means. I don't trust it at all. All right, let's get some engines started. Close up the doors here. Door sound effect. That's rad. That. Okay, external power's on. Gens are off right now. Set our condition up to ground idle. Turn our lights on just in case. Need a little light. Yeah, his plane is. I'm sure he has his plane. He can afford it. Order up. Oh, I forgot to turn my beacon on. Oh no. Someone might have been killed. Do it now. Daffy's Frog 41, there it is. I believe that is follower number 200. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for the follow. Say hi on chat. Let me know where you're watching from. I am up here in beautiful Portland, Oregon, where we are just about to fly to. Assuming it all goes well. Starter is up. Get the gen on. No power. Oh. Starter's still on. Maybe I have to put it up to flight idle. I probably should read a checklist for this plane at some point. Yep, there we go. And I forgot to set the parking brake, so we're going to roll into that Piaggio. There we go. Alright. Everything's fine. It's very professional. Professional operations here. Alright. Two on. Watching from Arkansas. Awesome, man. That's super cool. Never been to Arkansas. Traveled around a little bit last year. Went to Kansas City for the first time. That was pretty cool. But I've never been out that way. Alright. What's our cautions? No, we didn't run into the Avanti this time because I remembered in time. Step trim. This thing gets really chirpy. The trim is not set for takeoff. Flaps 15 here while we're thinking about it. Roll over here out toward Charlie. SGF. I don't know what airport that is. I'm usually pretty good with the codes. That one's new to me. Alright, break off. Roll out here to. When am I coming to Massachusetts? That's an excellent question. I've still never been to Boston, which is literally unacceptable.
American 1263, contact Oakland
really
Center, 132.95.
Oh, flying. Yeah, man, let's go. Now, you have an Archer, right?
Mike Charlie, listen to pass, express, and maintain
140 horse Archer, is that right? Am I remembering that correctly?
American 1263, Oakland Center, climb and take file 250.
Alright. Oak. Cherokee, that's right.
Salt Lake delivery, Delta.
Alright, ground is on 121.
To Portland this evening, ready to copy.
Delta 286, Salt Lake clearance, clearance under quest, standby.
Oh, you have the 180 converted.
Standby,
okay.
86.
Very nice. Alright, so. We're going to fly that back course on departure, so we don't need a heading set for now. We do have a climb up to 10,000. 10,000 is our initial, so we can set that in. It's already pretty close. Am I a controller on PE? No, actually, I'm not. I'm a staff member on PE. I have some virtual ATC experience on VATSIM, where I knew Keith for many years. We were on the VATSIM board of governors together, kind of the executive board that runs VATSIM. That's where I met Keith and really got impressed with his thoughts on virtual aviation and that sort of thing. I used to do ATC up in Seattle on VATSIM, but I've never done PE. I tried it once. I wasn't good enough. All right, let's figure out where the heck we're going here. Hey, Key Duffy. Good to see you, man. Thanks for stopping by. Yeah. Staff member.
Delta 286.
I don't get paid.
Claims schedule at Portland Airport. Twin Falls 3 departs for Twin Falls VOR. Then it's filed.
All right, we'll wait till this clearance is done. Climb VS-67
maintain 10,000. Departs your frequency 135.5. Squawk 5445.
We wait for him to read it back.
Delta 286 cleared Portland this evening on the Twin Falls 3. Twin Falls transition and its file claim. We have the SID 10,000 initial 135.5 on departure and 5445 on the box.
Too far ahead of ourselves is get my
panel. Delta 286 feedback correct.
On here. We're going to go Mustang.
San Francisco clearance delivery is Delta 273 with initial member request clearance to San Diego member.
We'll just sit
here. Delta 273, nothing. Take care of this. Refile, please.
I route. Alright. Here's J92. There you are. J92 to Windle. Falls. Easy enough. The falls to Portal. Next. X. Oh, Valdudes with the host. Thank you, man. Thank you, my friend. Thought you were streaming earlier. Sorry, I couldn't.
San Francisco clearance delivery, Delta 273. Filed flight plan. Requesting clearance to San Diego with information November.
I think that's a.
Delta 273, I still have nothing on file.
On Demoxy, but that's okay. We'll deal with that. I could all work with magic. I could all work with a very patient and understanding wife. It's the real answer for that. All right. Well, that guy's still figuring out his flight plans. Let's get rolling here. Reno Ground, good evening. Pilatus 1, Victor Kilo with the weather near the tower for a taxi for departure.
Number 1, Victor Kilo, Reno Ground, runway 16 left, taxi via Charlie.
Charlie to 16 left, 41 Victor Kilo. D91 with the auto host. Appreciate that. Auto hosting is the best thing to come around in Twitch, man. It's so cool. Scene Q with the host. Thank you very much. We've got all the GSA guys out tonight doing the host, looking out for the team. I appreciate that. Makes a big difference. Get those viewers, those eyeballs. What level charm spell do I use? See, you're just born with this, man. What can I say? We should turn our taxi light on. Why not? Alright. Do a Southwest taxi here. Blow this pop stand. I like this scenery. I wish it had more signs. I could be a little bit more confident we're going the right way, but Peter's nice. He'll tell us. If we get down to the end of the wrong runway, he'll say, hey, you went the wrong way. Oh, yeah. 40 knot taxi. Right side gens is on, but it doesn't come on until you go to flight idle. I haven't figured out why that is. Maybe someone who knows the plane can tell me why that is. What are we coming up on here? Hello. We need to slow down. Torb! Thank you for the host, sir. Appreciate it. Okay, here's a sign. Charlie to the right. All right, we can do that. Taxi in like 23 knots. Pretty sure that it's not, in point of fact, allowed. But that's all right. As we have discovered, I'm very professional. Very experienced. Got Dr. Torb in the house. Y'all should follow Turbinator 97 if you're not following him. He does some awesome streams flying pilotage on Pilot Edge. Yeah, you know what? It's not a taxi simulator, all right? If you want to watch someone race cars, you watch race cars. All right. Break on. Be off landing on. Yeah, Gen 2's on, as you can see, but the power is doing nothing at all. I don't know why. Let's see here. Tower is on 0.7. Departure frequency was 119.2. Oops. Finicky. I went the wrong way. I'm realizing this now. Oop. All right. Transponder altitude. In addition to flight idle, flaps are good. Lights are on. We do not have clearance, so we'll get that in a second. Just running through the departure in my head one more time. We are to fly this back course, which is programmed already on here in nav mode, to 3DME, then turn left direct to Mustang. We will get that heading off here. Rob KBTL, thank you for the host. Appreciate that. Rob and I have been friends for a long, long, long time. I did remember to start the FS economy, or the X economy client, so doing better than usual. We will climb to 10,000 here, and then we will depart Mustang later. We'll worry about that later. All right, let's get some clearance. Reno Tower, good evening. Pilatus 1, Victor Kilo, short of 1-6 left with the rudder ready to go.
For 1, Victor Kilo, we are turning 1-6 left, clear for takeoff, wind calm.
Wind calm, clear for takeoff, 1-6 left, 1 Victor Kilo. When this thing is on flight idle instead of ground idle, it goes fast. Like, even idling on the throttle will get you up to 30 knot taxi without any trouble at all. And it will also massively over-torque itself if you let it. So we're going to watch the torques real careful. Yep, see, we're already in the yellow. And I'm like, I got another quite a bit of throttle here. Takeoff. This thing does not need that much runway.
San Francisco clears delivery Delta 273.
We are pretty high.
Requesting clearance to San Diego International with information number.
Okay, watching this DME right down here. It's counting down for right now. We'll count down and count up soon. We'll grab that radial. It's in.
Delta 273, San Francisco clearance, say equipment suffix.
Equipment, Lima.
Got a weird little terrain thing going on over here.
Delta 273, Roger, get to the San Diego Lindbergh International Airport. Officer 1, departure Mickey transition in his file. Climb via city except maintain 10,000. Expect flight level 350, 10 minutes after departure.
There it is.
Hello. Departure frequency 135.1, squawk 1305.
Yeah, we're really close to the localizer, so it's going to deflect. I'm at
okay,
50,
we're cleared
to
San Diego International.
All right.
The offshore
well, I'm
departure.
A little
Mickey transition
slower than that right now because I want to get high quick.
Expect
really
350,
don't
want to
hold
minute,
over Mustang.
I'm going to
avoid it.
Departure frequency 135.1, and we'll squawk 1035 Delta 273.
Delta 273, is that correct?
DME is at 1.1.
For 1 Victor Kilo, radar and contact departure.
You can't say radar contact. Or departure 1 Victor Kilo, see ya. NorCal departure, good evening. Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo through 6,404, 10,000.
1 Victor Kilo. NorCal departure, radar contact, climb and maintain flight level 190.
190 for 1 Victor Kilo. Alright, we are just about coming up on that.
We're 326 Mike Charlie, contact Salt Lake City Center, 132.25.
Turn left.
56 Mike Charlie, Salt Lake City, Mustang. Center to pass this crest and maintain 17,000 to Salt Lake City, altimeter 3033.
That'll be a 20 heading right now. My voice is half that of the PE voice. All right, well, we can turn the PE voice down a little bit. We can fix that. I can hear myself fine, so it's hard to judge. John Fly, thank you for the host, sir. Appreciate that. All right. Now that we are more or less on course here, I'll let this thing do its climb. Altitude select. There it is. I need a solution for that. That's not going to drive me crazy. That is for sure. Okay. Climb is set. We're probably almost to Mustang. We are pretty close to almost to Mustang. So let's get ready to deal with that. I'm not using the GPS for this flight. I will use it if we need it to bail us out. Depart Mustang on the 314 radio. Let's throw that in there. 17. Turn this all the way around. We're almost to Mustang. We got under a mile to go.
Delta 600, pencil your park, but probably to one.
The most annoying thing. I need John Fly's voice recognition. You need to just say set course 314 and be like, okay. All right. Yeah. Go grab that radio. Yes, the fade in, fade out of the sectional. Yeah, I got a couple little technical tricks up my sleeve on this stream. I got a couple things I like to do. As I've said before to many people, programming the AV of
this. 1 Victor Kilo, contact Oakland Center, 132.2.
32.2 for 1 Victor Kilo. Programming the AV of the stream is almost as much fun as the flying itself. For me, anyway. Oakland Center, good evening. Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo through 12,900 for 190.
Plus 1-2 Victor, correction, pass 1 Victor Kilo, open center, climb attains altitude 220.
Up to 220 for 1 Victor Kilo. There, I turned myself up a little bit, and I'm going to turn ATC up just a scotch, too. So I can hear. Okay. This is my favorite way to fly, because you have to pay attention pretty much the whole time. Can't just sit here and let the plane fly itself. So, we are on Juliet 92 now, just out of Reno, on our way to Wendell. Up to Klamath Falls. I'm going to go ahead and put that in nav 2 real quick. I don't know if we'll be able to pick it up all the way out here. But that'll give us a nice little... Yeah, we can't see it yet, but that's okay. I'm also... Make sure our speed's doing okay. Yeah, speed's great. I'm going to put a... direct to Portland on here. We're not going to use it, but I want to...
Delta 273, San Francisco, same position on the airport.
I want a vector of where we're going, Andy, just in case we need it. Hope to not need it. Want it all the same. Okay. Yeah, so ETE right now is 154. That's based on our current speed. Once we get up to 220, we should get even better performance out of this thing. We are a little heavy. Got 10 passengers in the back. Oh, come on, GPS. Okay. They're invisible, but they're heavy because they're FSC passengers. And we got about 75% gas, so this thing could definitely go faster than it's going to go tonight, but hopefully we'll get a friendly wind. And once we finish our climb out, we should
pick up some speed here.
Meantime, time for a beverage. I'm going to need some help for that 12-hour stream. And I am going to be parched. I need to be basically chugging honey tea pretty much all day. Sent out my sim computer for evaluation. Oh no! No sim computer? No Torb streams? That's a shame. What's wrong with it? What's going on? Put Klamath Falls in the back up here. Get ready to set our altimeters. As you can see, Gen 2 is now mysteriously working again. Mysterious. Ah, blue screens. That's no good. Nothing is more frustrating when you're doing a sim or anything to have a crash or system blue screens, even worse than an X-Plane crash or a Gizmo crash or something like that. But that sucks, man. Alright, altimeter back to standard. I don't really know how to flight plan this thing because it's not in SimBrief, which is what I usually use for planning. The profile's not in there. So, hey, Jake Allen in the house. Good to see you, sir. So I don't really know what cruise altitude would be best for this. I didn't run the winds and do all the things that I normally do because SimBrief doesn't know about this plane's performance. So I don't want it to put me at an altitude that would be great for a Saab 340, but bad for a little Pilatus. So, a little experimentation. We're coming up on a tile border here. Time to go back to a Mac. Ooh, fighting words. I use a Mac all day, every day for my work, and I'm a personal machine, and I like it, but I'm a PC for sim. Wish I knew why these borders were so defined. I'm using the same source for everything, and yet they still kind of come out this sharp border on the tiles. Kind of annoying. I mean, you can't complain too much because it's free software and the graphics are awesome. For free stuff, the quality is great, but it'd be nice to not have those sharp edges. Stream X-Plane 10 on your smartphone. Does anyone do that yet? That'd be funny. Get air server going. Stream plan, X-Plane Mobile. Oh yeah. That'd be extremely professional. Alright. Looking at my chart one more time. Windle is 60 miles from Mustang. We are currently 23 miles from Mustang, so we're coming up on that in a little while here. I noticed the high altitude charts don't have changeover points the way low altitude ones do. I must just figure you can figure that out for yourself, I guess.
The Delta 286, verify Bravo 5 or Hotel 5. There's no Bravo 5 at the airport.
Up on 220, then we should speed up.
Oh, you're off the gate, Bravo. I'm sorry, you're saying that you're by the intersection of Bravo 5. Runway 34 right
now. I do want to throttle it down a little bit, not run it full blast all the way. Unlike most of my usual flights, this is an FS economy flight. 326, so
Mike Charlie, contact.
We are sort of paying for the gas.
City approach 128.1.
1,000 to go. Does not have a wind readout, which is too bad. Not that I can see anyway. I would think it would be down here somewhere. Also, I've not really experimented with this thing. I believe this is, yeah, it's a map with some fixes. I think it'll do traffic too, so we'll see if we need that later. Yes, yes. Coming up on holding, I know. Alright. Let's see what our speed level's out at.
356, Mike Charlie, Salt Lake City approach. Expect the ILS when we 34 right approach. And you can proceed via the land north transition. I think this is kind of during the transition on the arrival.
Bring the temps down a little bit. This thing does have quite a range. It can get, I think, 1,000 nautical miles. I don't know about with full gas. But we should be fine. Alright, picking up some speed now. Check the load here.
Tell the truth, no need to ready in this call tower when you're ready for departure.
Got 594 kilograms of industrial parts on the way to Portland. Job is worth 3,786 virtual dollars. Not a ton, but it's a good excuse to go to Portland. I've never seen out of that. Alright, now we're getting an ETA that's a little better.
I'm not picking up your transponder, verify transponder.
I'm gonna set my estimate, my fancy estimator here. Don't have a TOC TOD, but I do have we can do an estimated landing. I'm gonna guess we're gonna be on the ground about 95 minutes. 21:29 my time.
Delta 273,
go
runway 1 left there for takeoff.
In just a second, we can see how we do. We'll update that if we get a significant
heading
wind change.
120 vectors to final, descend and maintain 12,000.
show this off too. Probably heard me talk about this if you know me at all, but in a couple weeks, Saturday, February 11th, I'm planning to do a 12 plus hour stream, trying to complete the Day in the Life challenge, which is something Peter, the guy actually who's doing the controlling right now, put together. He was a real world airline pilot before we hired him away for Pilot Edge, and he put together a schedule on the PE forums of 5 flights. The challenge is to fly them all with basically a half hour break on the ground between each one, which includes like meal, bio, pre-flight, post-flight, all that stuff. Real weather, real time. I'm going to try it. I'm going to give it a shot, and I'm going to stream the whole thing. So Saturday, February 11th, on my Twitch, Tim P. So if you're not already following, toss me a follow and you can come along. Should be starting around 9 o'clock in the morning, and we'll be going well into the evening. Hopefully we'll get it all done before the network closes at 11. I'm not sure how long my voice will last.
Delta 273, contact departure.
We will see. It should be a good time.
Delta 273, NorCal departure radar contact, climb at TFL 190.
Alright, organize things here a little bit here. Check the latest weather at Portland. Wind 110 at 8, so we'll probably land on the 10s. Visibility 10, broken at 1,700, overcast at 11,000, so.
For 326, Mike Charlie, contact Salt Lake City, approach 125.7.
Probably could do a visual, but with that broken layer, I'll probably take an ILS into one of the 10s. 10 left is the one that's closer to where the GA parks, so I'll probably try and get that if I can.
326 Mike Charlie, Salt Lake City, approach sliding 160, descend and maintain 8,000.
Alright, 10 miles to Windle. That's at 60 DME. We are now receiving Klamath Falls. Yeah, 9 a.m. West Coast time, exactly. Yep. Receiving Klamath Falls, and at that point we'll make our turn north, and we may need to use the GPS for that one. Looking at this, that route as you go off script there a little bit. It's not on an airway. So once we get closer to Klamath Falls, we can figure that out. Klamath Falls Airport's right there, so going the right way.
For 326, Mike Charlie, 5 miles from Packer, fly heading 010, maintain 8,000 till established on Little Glider, cleared ILS and wait 34 right approach.
Once we get to 60 here on this distance, I'll switch us over to track Klamath inbound instead of Reno outbound, or Mustang outbound, that way we don't lose it and start flying all over the place.
Delta 286, contact departure.
Yeah. There's some traffic. And we're in the western area, so that's almost certainly not a drone. Oh, where'd it go? There it is. Let's go see if we can find him. Doo-doo. Pretty far away.
Delta 286, Salt Lake departure radar contact, climb and HFL 230.
Nice polygon model there. It's a little far, so we got the
Delta 273, contact Oakland Center, 127.45.
That's funny. Traffic
normal. 326, yeah. Mike, keep that turn going, heading 310.
Let's turn the range down on this and see. Oh, interesting. I haven't messed with this that much before. I don't really know what it does, to be honest with you. Can't tell if it's just a map. It looks kind of like the X-Plane default map. I was hoping it would show traffic. Yeah, no train map. Weather
Delta 273 off right center, now. Climb maintain file 350.
Alright. I'll keep an eye on it. Meantime. Use the old eyeball. Can't tell if he's paused. We're just moving slowly. One of the two. Let's see if we can go find him on the map. Time to sleep in. Gives you time to sleep in. Doesn't give me much time to sleep in. That's alright. It's all about you guys. All about the viewers. Interesting. Nobody out here. So maybe it is a drone. Maybe we might have recorded a couple drones for the San Francisco airspace back in the day. I don't know why it stopped, though. That's kind of weird. Maybe it's a UFO. Alright.
Number 326, Mike Charlie, contact Salt Lake City Tower, 119.05.
We reached that point. What was it called again? Oh yeah, Wendell. Alright, so let's go ahead and ever so briefly switch to heading mode. And make this switch here. Plymouth Falls. Inbound.
For 326 Magnolia, Salt Lake City Tower, runway 34 right, clear to land.
This thing do its little capture dance here. Hour and 15 to go. The other thing about the day in the live stream that I'm super excited about is giveaways. I've heard back from two vendors so far, actually three technically. We've got a total of 8 giveaways already. I would love to get to the point where I'm able to do one giveaway per hour, just because it'll help pass some of the time up at cruise and keep things moving. So I have a couple more emails out to people who just haven't gotten back to me yet. But yeah. Should be a good time. We got some add-ons, got some planes. Should be a good time. Just over 100 miles to go. It's like about 26 minutes. Plymouth Falls, total Time and route's down about 1 hour and 17 minutes according to the GPS. I put it at 1 hour and 15. That might have been a little optimistic. Keep an eye on it.
Delta 286, contact Salt Lake City Center, 128.72.
Just refreshed my Twitch dashboard and saw some magical words, which I pasted there in the chat.
For Griffin Delta 286, solid
200 followers. Thank you all very much for that. I mean it. If the GSA guys, John Fly and Rob and Kat are still watching out there, I appreciate you letting me into your little club. Appreciate the work that you've done to help promote my little stream. Started streaming again after taking about 2 years off, about 3 weeks ago. And I think at that time I had about 150, 160, something like that. So to be able to get up to 200 so quick is a testament to the promotional power of the Global Sim Alliance. Good night, Clocky. Have a good one, man. I'm doing a little late night streaming since I'm here on the West Coast. It's only 8 o'clock here, but I know. For many viewers, it is getting late, and it is a school night and a work night and all the and everything night. I get it. I don't know if we'll be able to do another leg after this one. I had hoped to be able to go down from Portland to Baker City, which is a municipal airport that I think is about, I want to say that's about 70 nautical miles. So it's not too far. We might have time to sneak that in. We'll just kind of see how it's looking.
For 1 Victor Kilo, contact Seattle Center 121.4.
121.4 for 150 kilo. Yeah, I know. East Coasters, it's getting late. I gotcha. No worries. 21.4. Seattle Center, good evening. Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo 220.
For 1 Victor Kilo, Seattle Center, I think.
Portland to Baker City is more like 208. Though it is a little farther than I thought it was. Still. Yeah. 48 minutes. Yeah. I don't think we'll be able to sneak that one in tonight. That's too bad. I was hoping to do that. It always sounds good. Every time I'm planning a stream, I'm always like, oh, I'm going to go here, and I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do this. And I'm always very optimistic about how long it'll take to get set up, and on the departure takes and all the flight planning that I do. And this took longer than usual because I wasn't using my usual sim brief system where you just spit in where you want to go and it's like, oh, okay, here's your route, here's your altitude, here's your fuel. Change. I'm pretty pleased with this pile mic, though. I need to get a shock mount for it so I can tap it without making it noisy, but I just had this mic lying around in my garage, and I think it's going to work out pretty well. I have enough background noise that a condenser mic wasn't a good fit, but this thing seems to work pretty well. Needs a little noise gate. Makes me sound better. Wouldn't go straight to good, but it makes me sound better. Steve Kirks, you still in the house? You want to talk to me about how this pressurization system works? I've never touched it. I just let it be. I assume it knows what to do. But I would love to know how it actually works. If you are in the building. Paging Steve Kirks. Steve Kirks to a Twitch chat, please. There he is.
American 250, Albuquerque Center, descend via the Hyder.
Arizona Flyer, hello, good evening to you. Yeah, ECS and Auto, I thought that might be the case. Every time I see something off, gets my attention. We'll just turn that
on. Runway 7 right for American 250.
All the passengers died of hypoxia some time ago.
3-2 Sigma Charlie, where you're parking this evening.
But, we'll pressurize it from now.
6 Mike Charlie, under right turn on Sierra Kilo to the ramp, cross runway 1. Actually, it's a Sierra Romeo Kilo to the ramp.
This one?
Cross runway 1.
Ah, I see.
Romeo.
Okay. Alright. Ah, I gotcha. So now. Okay. Got it. Okay, so this controls the cabin climb rate. What toggles you between the... Oh, I see. Aircraft. Yep, I got it. I gotcha. Yeah, okay, so we can pressurize up to 26. And it will keep the cabin at 22,000 to 7,000 feet. Okay. Got it. That's pretty easy. And then I'm assuming for descent, it will it track it automatically? Or do I need to come back here and tell it my landing altitude? And let it depressurize us on the way down? I'm used to my 737 where it's all like... Well, it's not simpler, but it's, I understand it better anyway. Yeah, leave it be. Okay. We will leave it be. For descent, just put field elevation in cabin alt. Okay. That makes sense. That's the same thing we were just setting here. Easy is right. Alright, excellent. See? We learned a thing. Learned how to not kill our passengers. Very, very important. We want to be a serious flight simulation channel. We need to learn how to not kill people. Ideally. Although we are hauling industrial parts this time for FS Economy, and we have a mask. So, maybe it's not that important. Alright, 20 minutes to Klamath Falls. So let's figure out what we're going to do after that. I'm going to go program in. I'd hope to not have to use the GPS for this flight and just kind of fly it slant alpha. But our route does not quite allow that. So we'll not do that. Yes, the VOR. Now. Set. You know, let's look at the arrival before we do this. Let's not get ahead of ourselves here. Timber's arrival. Oh my! This arrival has 3 pages. Page 1.
Delta 273, contact Los Angeles Center, 133.55. G'day.
So my flight plan was in the wrong order. I had Portal and then Moxie, but it's Moxie then Portal. My bad. Yeah, there's page 2. And there's page 3. But we're going to pick this up from Moxie. It says at or above 240. That'll just have to be okay, though. We're going to have to deal with that. Moxie Portal Timbers. Alright, get that done first. Perhaps we should not have chosen an RNAV SID in an aircraft with no FMC. That may not have been the wisest thing we've ever done. That's okay. We will persevere. There we go. All right. not to Timbers. We'll also have to take care of the vertical planning here as well. Because my guess is we'll probably get a descent pilot's discretion. Timbers to Vance to Flower. Beyond that, we need to know which way Portland is landing, which we have a guess, but we don't know for sure. So I'm just going to put Vance and Flower in there for now. My guess is we'll probably get vectored off the arrival before then. Flower.
American 250, contact Phoenix Approach 128.65.
Or not that flower, different flower. All right, so after Klamath Falls, which we're coming up on here in not too long, just about 15 minutes, we will turn direct Moxie, direct Portal, Timbers, Vance, Flower.
American 250, Phoenix Approach, expect to visit approach runway 7 right.
I feel a little bad, because we're supposed to be at or above flight level 240 at Moxie, and we're cruising at 220, so that's not going to happen. But the good news is getting down to in between 11,000 and 240 by portal would be no problem. This thing shouldn't be at 270 IAS anyway. I suppose that's another issue, isn't it? We have a plane that can't fly the arrival speeds that for the star that we fly. Not ideal. Maybe we should fly this arrival. It starts from the same place and has much less in the way of crossing restrictions. It's also much simpler. It's designed for planes like ours. That probably would be a good idea. Let's see if we can do that. Seattle Center, Pilatus 1, Victor Kilo. We're just noticing the Timbers 2 arrival has some restrictions we're not going to be able to comply with. Can we refile for the Moxie 6 arrival, please?
Burr 1, Victor Kilo. Roger, after Moxie cleared to Portland via the Moxie 6 arrival.
Okay, after Moxie cleared to Portland via the Moxie 6 arrival. Thank you very much, 1, Victor Kilo. Sunik, thank you for the follow. Appreciate that. The good news is a lot of our work here was not wasted because, as you can see, a lot of the fixes here are actually the same as the ones we just programmed in. We go Moxie, Portal. You know, due to Timbers. I suppose I should see if I can clear that one out. Let's see if we can do that. I don't actually really know how to do that. Ha! You just hold down clear. Sweet. Moxie, Portal, Vance, O City. Okay, so we need to change Flower to be O City. Stands for Oregon City. True story. Alright, no, we still have Flower on there, but we'll blow it up. Alright, after O City, we will be given a vector for the final approach course. Lost comms, direct to battleground. Easy enough. Valdudes, 33 viewer host. Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate that very much. That is very kind of you. Alright. Back to here. We are on our way into Portland, Oregon. We are a PC-12, beautiful little single LTRM crew, thank you much for the follow. Appreciate that. Little single turboprop. Doing some FS economy legs here, or at least one leg. Took off out of Reno. And, yeah. Pretty smooth so far. Weather's clear. Go see what the latest is in Portland. Yep, hasn't changed. Broken at 1,700, overcast at 11,000. So we'll probably still shoot the ILS just to make sure everything's good to go. Don't run into any weirdness. Now that we have our route programmed in, I will switch this over to track the GPS. Does mean we lose our little next waypoint down there, but we can look on here and have it. What's that? 100 says he lives in Reno. He or she lives in Reno. That is awesome. I've never been there. Been to Vegas many times. Never been to Reno as an adult. As a kid, I think my parents took me there once, but didn't leave too much of an impression on a 5-year-old. Sorry to say.
American 250, contact Phoenix Approach 120.
That 100. Thank you so much for the follow. Appreciate that. Val dudes sent his dudes here. I appreciate that. Welcome to all Val dudes. If you're not already following Val dudes, you should. He does some excellent streams. Very laid back streamer. My kind of guy. Doesn't take things too seriously.
American 250, Phoenix.
Heck of a pilot, though. Watched him fly the Roaring Fork visual into Aspen, and I think it was an Airbus 330. Made a turn that would have sent some Kaitok pilots probably back home. Pretty cool, so. Gooby-Doo 33, hello. Good evening to you. I know I've seen you on the old Valdude stream before. Good to see you here. We're celebrating some 200 hype tonight. Pushed over 200 followers on our stream, which, as I said earlier, is mind-blowing to me, considering just a couple weeks ago I was still in the 150-160 range. Testament to the power of the Global Sim Alliance. Appreciate all those guys have done for me in the last couple days. Not only letting me in, but sending the hosts my way, sending the viewers my way, helping me build the stream. Technically the small LA, yeah. I hear that. It is fun to fly in and out of, I'll tell you that. Not having been to the city itself, can't comment too much on its merits there, but the airport is nice, and the approaches sure are fun. Landing at 4,500 feet, and there's some interesting, you know, kind of a wind tunnel effect you get down that valley. I once knew someone who flew back from Reno, and they said after that flight they were pretty much done with flying for a little while because it was so turbulent. We haven't had anything like that yet in the sim, but we still got another couple days, but while it's still our bonus field, so should be fun. Songhammer, hello. Good evening to you. Hope you're having a good night.
American
Thanks for the follow.
Thank
Appreciate
you,
that.
Sir, this person, my 7 right.
You guys that are following, I appreciate the follow. Feel free to say hi on chat, too, as well. We got some time on our hands up here, so we can chat. Let me know where you're watching from. Where in the world? Nice airport, but this time of year it's a mess. Why do you say that? Is it just the winter, or what's messy about it? I am having a great night, Songhammer. Thank you very much. Just up here streaming with my pals. Good place to be. Florida, excellent. DRD 7710. Hello, good evening to you. Thank you for the follow. I'll also take a brief moment, if you'll indulge me. Look at my Discord. Gooby-Doo 33, you the best. Thank you so much. Chevy's watching from Alderaan. Good luck with that. I won't tell you what's coming. You'll be fine. Discord-wise, if you're a Discord user, stop on by. The stream's still small, so the community is still small. It's a great chance to chat with some other simmers, some real cool folks in there. We'd love to see you. That's good. I'm sure it'll work out fine. You got that 45-year mortgage on your house there on Alderaan? All right, 25 miles to Klamath Falls. after that, we make the turn to Oxy. The default 530 does not have a ETA on it, which is a bit of a shame. I predicted earlier we'd be on the ground in about 55 minutes from now. You can see my little prediction up there. I don't know if we're gonna make that. I'll tell you right now. Been a little windier up here. We got a little more headwind than I was hoping for. Blew up some unknown planet we disguised as Alderaan. Empire is full of stupid people. You know, that's funny. I'll give you that. But that sort of thing actually happened in World War II. There was a whole squad of guys that worked for the British and set up, like, fabric-covered, like, tents and painted them to look like tanks. And the Germans would send over all their bombers and wipe out these tanks. And it was basically just, you know, some canvas and poles.
250 Phoenix Tower went
and meanwhile, the real tanks were, like, rolling away. They used mirrors to disguise the movements, or they would use, you know, special effects to make it seem like there was a whole division of troops when it really was just, like, 10 guys. Pretty interesting. Battlefield misdirection. So definitely was a real thing back then. I can only imagine what they do now. In some ways, I'm sure it's easier. All the digital stuff. Not doing so much visual bombing and that sort of thing. On the other hand, those systems can be confused just as easily as the eye can. Sometimes easier, so. We're coming up on Crater Leap. Pretty sure. Yeah. I think we'll fly almost right over it. No. Clear Lake Reservoir. Upper Klamath Lake. Goose Lake. Just looking at the sectional here. You might as well look at what I'm looking. Chest is off to our left. There it is. Hello. Hello, Shasta. Looking here to see if I can find what we're looking at the front. Yeah, I guess that's this. I guess that's Upper Klamath. That's cool. Landmark hunting is fun when you got all the ortho tiles and stuff. Turns these flights from just passing time to getting to look around and actually see stuff. I believe that's Klamath Falls Airport there in front of us. Yep. That's Pelican Butte over there. That little top that we can't hardly see yet, I think. Or perhaps Mount McLaughlin. It's one of these two. See if we can see the other one next to it. Wait till we get a little closer. Alright. Our new and improved arrival. One that we can actually fly in this class of aircraft. That was a good move. After Klamath Falls, direct to Moxie to Portal, which we can expect to cross at 10,000. Vance, O City, and then the airport's just straight ahead, so we basically get sent for vectors right at O City. If you're just joining us, you missed some drama. I originally had filed the Timbers 2 arrival into Portland because that's what a Horizon Dash 8 had flown. And I figured, Dash 8, PC-12, they're both props, should be fine. I did not realize that was an RNAV star, so it was a little more complicated than I felt like programming. And it also had some crossing restrictions that this plane literally just is incapable of, like making 280 indicated. Which, as you can see, with this little red line, is not a good idea. So, I had to refile. A little embarrassing. Thankfully, the controller was gracious about it. Good lesson to read all the charts before you file the flight plan, not just the departure. I want to look at the lake some more. This is cool.
American 250 Gulf 7.
Peter's gracious.
To, Foxtrot 9, Echo 9, Echo, Delta 9, Delta to the ramp
Peter's
across
nice
runway 25 right at Foxtrot 9.
Peter's on the East Coast. He's working ATC at 11:30 p.m. his time.
Yeah, Foxtrot, they have not named the taxi level here. You can just left off of Gulf 7
tired.
On the Foxtrot, immediate right turn, that'll be Foxtrot 9.
Alright, we're gonna make this turn onto into Klamath Falls.
It looks like you went right on Foxtrot instead of left.
25 seconds. Once we do that, I need to run upstairs for just a sec.
And
we will wait till I make that turn. Make sure everything works. Everything's working fine. And then I will step away for just a mo.
American 250 affirmative. Once you cross, it'll be the second pack. So on your left will be Delta. You can take Delta all the way to the ramp.
Flipping out because we're over the cross point. Yeah, Cat was streaming Doom earlier. It's interesting. It's not what I'm used to seeing our friend Cat's Trader doing. It's a little different. Seattle Center plot is one victory. Kilo, we're going to step away for about 3 minutes. Please.
One victory, Roger.
I will be right back.
Delta 286, approved, report back.
Alright. Center plot is one victor, Kilo's back.
That's one victor, Kilo, Roger.
All good. That is pretty. I haven't spent much time in this area of Oregon. I live in Portland, but I don't get down here too often. From the air, sure looks nice. Three minutes left on your flight. Where are you flying, man? Bird, Rogue Valley off the left wing. Need a better reference card. Yeah. That's the thing about Sims, man. White Sim will chew up any possible PC you throw at it. It doesn't matter how shit hot your PC is. X-Plane or Baird or FSX will make it feel like a 5-year-old piece of junk. And then you play something else, some other game that was just released, and it runs at like 90 frames per second. You're like, oh, that's right. I do have a good computer. I just forgot, because I'm a flight simmer. Ah, Salt Lake to Reno. Excellent. That's cool. I've flown the reverse of this route. I flew Portland to Reno on stream a couple days ago. We went from Reno to Santa Barbara in the 737-300. That was fun. That was enjoyable. This is definitely a little more relaxed, a little more slower pace. 240 over the ground instead of 490. I'd hope we get a little more out of this thing, but I think we've got a headwind that's hitting us pretty hard, so. Alright, there's Crater Lake up there. Look at that. That is beautiful. Once we get closer, we should get even better resolution on that. We'll have to take a good look at that as we pass over the top of it.
That's 36 minutes.
This is the main arrival into Portland for traffic from the south. So I've flown in real life along this routing many times, and pilots will usually point out mountains and Crater Lake, because if you open that window, you can see some. It's just gorgeous. Just gorgeous. After that to Sacramento, excellent. Let's go. What are you flying in? Technically, we're on the arrival right now, because we just passed Klamath Falls a minute ago. Now, you can tell it's not, yeah, chart not to scale. You can tell that's true, because this leg is 128 miles, and this leg is 26. So, really, Klamath Falls should be way down, like, below. We'll go Klamath Falls, and then from Moxie, it's pretty much a straight line, a beeline for Portland. DMC Airboss, hello. True airspeed. Got my ground speed. Got my indicated. I don't know that we have a readout from the true. I suppose we can figure it out, though. Oh, Embraer 190. Nice, man. That's right. What is it? Half your altitude? I forget exactly what the rule is for. Tests. I'm spoiled. I've been flying airliners, man. Airliners just tell you this stuff. I'm not a real world pilot, so I don't know all these. I don't know all the rules. I think it's half your altitude, and it's your indicated. We're indicating 50, 60, 70, 85 ish. So 290 something, is that right? Ground's 240, so. What's that? You flying the new X-Crafts Embraer? The V2? Or is it a different model? Got a little bug in the altimeter here. That's funny. We're at 21,000 feet. Yeah, ground speed's on the GPS right here. It's 244. Right there. You can also see it down here on the HSI. I'm just laughing at this altimeter. But it's a four-digit readout there. There we go. 21,998, 999. Oh, 22. We went from 22,000 to 22,000 the way it should be. That was funny. I might have to send a video of that to Carinato so they can see. Oh, look at that. That is cool. Yeah, performance for the PC-12. It's not the fastest plane in the world. It can get up fairly high. I think the ceiling is 280, something like that. It is pressurized, but it's just a single PT-6, so it's not nearly as fast as one of the, you know, the twins or the, you know, the big airliners. But it does hold. Oops. It can hold up to, I think, 11 people in airliner config. This one's in executive config. And on FS Economy, which is what we're using right now, it is a great little moneymaker, because you can stuff this thing full of people and fly it around, and it doesn't use hardly any gas, so. This is the Carinato PC-12, which I just bought a couple days ago. I've always loved PC-12s. I used to fly the Flight 1 PC-12 all over the dang place. So I'm pretty pleased with this model so far. I'm still working on landing it a little bit. You'll see when we get down closer to Portland. For a plane that flies an approach at 90 knots, it's pretty easy to plant it down at 500 feet per minute, so. Still working on landing it softly, I should say. But other than that, it's a pretty much a joy to fly. Right in between the Bonanza, which I do a lot of flights in, and then the 737, the IXEG, and the other airliners that I've been also getting into the last couple weeks. But yeah, Airbus, thanks, man. Thanks for stopping by. Glad you found us. About 20 minutes to Moxie. Yeah. I originally said 40 minutes to be on the ground. That's what our little estimator is. I don't know. I suppose it could be possible. We'll see. I'm not going to adjust it. I set that like an hour ago, and that was even a kind of a guess based on what the GPS was telling me for a direct routing, not the not flying the indirect arrival. As you can see, we've got kind of a dogleg here that will slow us down slightly than if we had flown direct. So trying to get better at estimating times and tracking times and that sort of thing, because for the Day of the Life challenge, one of the parameters of the challenge that's actually like the parameter that I'm the most worried about is that you have to do 5 flights in a total of 9 flight hours due to an FAA duty maximum regulation. So we have to get from Elko, Nevada to Salt Lake. I think from Salt Lake to Montrose, Colorado. Montrose to Denver. Denver to Phoenix. Phoenix to San Diego. San Diego to Seattle, I think. I think that's right. I may have added one extra there. But anyway, do all that in 9 hours. And if you're like close on the end, you can still depart San Diego. San Diego's the longest one. Very cruel. The longest flight is last. So we're going to be stressing like right up to the last minute to see if we can get it in under the under the cap. I mean, it's all for fun. I'm going to have a good time either way. I'm not actually stressed about it because we're just going to have a good time. But, yeah. Easy doing the Concorde. Yeah, well, that feels like cheating to me.
At 41 Oakland Center.
We're going to do it in our slow little 737-300. But I will tell you what we are going to do. We are going to crank that cost index up to 200. Because we are not paying for gas. And we are going to fly the hell out of that thing. We're not doing FS Economy for those flights. We're not paying for that. We're going to be right at right at the VNE. I was a 727. Yeah, I thought about that. So the thing about that is I've been flying the IXEG for the last 3 or 4 weeks, and I've been streaming it, so you are also interested in flying the IXEG or want to learn how to fly it, or at least watch someone make a lot of mistakes and learn how as he goes. Check out my YouTube. I post all my streams in high-quality video there, so you can see what we did. And I just am now feeling confident that I can actually fly that thing without screwing it up, without causing a gizmo crash. And yeah, it can only, you know, it can do Mach 0.75, I think, or 7.6 is where it tops out. It's not nearly as fast as the 727 is capable, but that 727 is way more complicated. Systems are more complicated, the engines, the pressurization, all that stuff. And I do want to have a prayer of completing the challenge. It'll be funny either way. We'll have a good time either way. I'll stream the whole thing either way. Even if we're out of time, I'll finish it off and I'll stream it until we're done. But it would be nice to be, like, competitive and actually feel like we might have a chance. It's just a big Skyhawk. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the 727 is not just a big Skyhawk. Skyhawks don't have dedicated flight engineers in the cockpit. At least the ones I fly don't. Gizmo crash equals challenge over. I know. We had one. We had a gizmo crash right after departure on my last stream. We were flying Reno to Santa Barbara. And I committed the cardinal sin of trying to change departure runways on the procedure, and that was it, man. Gizmo was like, we're done. But we pressed on, and it actually was fine, though. The rest of the flight was fine. So I was, like, completely nervous the whole rest of the way that it was going to have a problem. But it ended up being no big deal. So as part of the challenge, we do have to reset the plane to cold and dark at Montrose, I think after the second leg, either the second or the third. So that will be a good opportunity to let Gizmo take a little time out. And with the exception of aligning the IRS, I'm pretty sure I can pre-flight that thing fast enough that if we had to do a plane reset after each leg and do a cold and dark, we could do it. Aligning the IRS takes 13 minutes, so that's kind of a bummer. Because we have a 30-minute time on ground for each one of those legs. We have to be quick about it, because that's not only, like, shutting the plane down, planning, briefing, pre-flighting, me getting food that I want to eat on the ground, me going to the bathroom, for example, and then we have to get going again. So we'll see. Maybe if we're early, we can make some time up there. That'd be good. Because one of the parts of the challenge, it's a real schedule, you can't leave until the scheduled time. So if you're early in the day, it does not really help you. Just gives you more break time, which I'll need. So, hello, Symbol. Good evening, sir. Good to see you. We are just on our way into Portland. We are technically on the arrival now, but since we are in a PC-12 and we're doing 240 across the ground, thanks to a, looks like about 40 knot headwind, we will be another 20 minutes at least before we are on the ground. So yes, the 50 step ortho process. Exactly. It's worth it, though. I don't know how long you've been watching, but we just flew over Crater Lake back there. It's already kind of loaded the lower res one. I actually want to redo this tile and get ZL-17 or maybe even 18 instead of this 16.
F-41 Oakland Center to send via the Surfer 2 arrival San Francisco altimeter 3014.
CMC Airboss, hello, thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. Just registered for Flight SimCon, says Mile High FSX reminder. Price goes up end of this month. That is an excellent reminder. I am actually going to try and make it out to Flight SimCon. We are at flight level 220 in our little trusty PC-12, chugging along. Yeah, Flight SimCon is in Connecticut at Bradley Airport, BDL. And I'm going to try to make it all the way from Portland. It's going to be a very long travel day, trying to find an itinerary that avoids having to take two connections to get there from here. But Keith is going, I'm pretty sure, from Pilot Edge. I believe a couple other controllers are going to try and make it. And then I know a whole bunch of the Global Sim Alliance guys are going to be there. I'm pretty sure John will be there. Pretty sure Cat Strader will be there. So, yeah. Have not been to Connecticut before. I was in Vermont a couple years ago, had a good time in the Northeast, and had a good time. So if it's not a hard sell to me to tell me I get to go and spend a couple days just nerding out about Flight Sims with a bunch of people that I enjoy talking to and enjoy watching their streams, and hang out with my friend Keith, who I work very closely with every single day and have for 5 years, and yet we've spent maybe 10 hours total in each other's physical presence, and it's been about 3 or 4 years since I last saw him in the flesh. So I will be flying from Portland, Oregon. So your mic sounds good. Excellent. Glad to hear it. I'm pleased with this mic. Steve Kirk's heading for bed. You have a good night, sir. Thank you for your assistance and your patronage of our humble little stream here. Thank you for helping me learn how to not kill the passengers by learning how to pressurize the airplane. Very important. Skill to possess. We should be getting a descent here pretty soon. The arrival tells us to expect portal at 10,000. From Moxie, we'll have 26 miles. Yeah, the nonstop to Boston actually is pretty tempting because I have Alaska MVP, so there's a pretty good chance I could get a first-class upgrade to and from Boston. I don't know how busy that flight usually is, but that would be nice. And then driving to Bradley. The other thing I was looking at is, I don't know for sure, so don't quote me on this, but if Keith is going to fly his Lancair 360 from New Jersey, then I will totally take a flight to Newark and fly to Bradley in Keith's Lancair. I will be compressed like a sardine can for however long it will take us to get there, because that Lancair is tiny, and I am not tiny. But I think that would be totally worth it to get to fly in Pilot Edge 1, the Lancair that Keith has. If that doesn't work out, though, yeah, I'm definitely thinking about doing the either going through Boston or driving up from somewhere like that. Somewhere where I can get an Alaska flight, get the best chance of getting that sweet, sweet MVP upgrade. Yeah, me and a Lancer. I know. We're not going to be able to take any luggage with us due to weight and balance, but it'll be fine. You can buy clothes once you get there. Yeah, I'm about 6'5", 6'6½. So Keith is not a tall man, and he has to like duck to close the canopy on that thing. I think he's about 5'11". So if that's the primary plan, there will definitely be a backup plan in case we try it out and it's like, oh no, this is a no-go. All right, starting to pick up that weather. Excellent. Newark to Bradley, about an hour in a Lancer. Yeah, that's what I was figuring. I mean, that thing is fast. That Lancer 360 has, that thing is super fast. So even if it's, if I can physically fit, even if it's not the most
comfortable, already went to contact North it will, approach, 1-2-1.
It'll go fast. It'll go by fast because that plane really cooks. Even with my fat ass in the right seat. Going over the rest of the Cascades here. A little haze coming in. Go check on Portland weather. Maybe we got a fresh meteor yet. Nope. Nothing yet. Alright.
NorCal approach, except the ILS runway 28 left approach.
I wonder where that guy's going. Because Portland has a 28 left, but the wind doesn't favor the 28s right now, so I doubt he's going.
For 1 Victor Kilo, cross vans that maintain 10,000, the Portland altimeter 3022.
3022 in Vance at 10,000 for 1 Victor Kilo.
Delta 286, contact Seattle Center 135.15.
Right, how long do we have to Vance from here? We have 80 miles. 80 miles to drop 12,000 feet is a pretty healthy amount of miles. So I'm inclined to...
Delta 286, Seattle
Center. Moxie to Vance is what? It's like about 50 miles? Okay. Now that's interesting. Did he give us Vance at 10,000? Instead of Portal at 10,000? Let's check and make sure. At Seattle 1 Victor Kilo, was that Vance at 10,000 or Portal at 10,000?
Advance
10,000, thanks.
Okay.
Well, that's fine. It gives us a little more time to get down. So we'll hang out. We'll hang out up here for a little bit more. We can start our descent probably right about the turn at Moxie. That seems like a good time to start on down. Remember to set the pressurization so that the cabin starts descending in time for the arrival. Oh no, don't let me forget that. All those of you who are watching our thrilling flight along here. A thrilling flight along where mostly everything has gone fine, and the only errors have been self-caused. Self-inflicted. Which is pretty much how it often goes for me, but... On every flight, we learn something, so. Yeah, 5 minutes to top a drop. I do think we're going to miss our 23-minute landing time, though. Even if we haul a lot of ass on the descent, which I plan to do, because why not? I don't think we'll be on the ground in 21 minutes. I think it'll be a little bit longer than that. Joys of not having the fancy FMS with VMAV and the fancy predictions and calculations and such. On an old school. as old school as this almost completely glass panel could be described to be. Quick look. We haven't formally been assigned this yet, but I'm expecting, and I'm going to try and get this approach, 10 left because of the winds, and Flightcraft, the executive FBO, is located like right here, right where the word tower is, or maybe the R in tower. That's where Flightcraft is, so if we land 10 left, it'll be a short taxi to go park. Pretty simple approach. Pretty simple ILS from mountains to the west of the field, but nothing to worry about too much. DVA 4695, hello. Good evening to you, sir. Thanks for stopping by. We are somewhere around 25 minutes out of Portland, Oregon, in a Pilatus PC-12, all in some industrial parts for FS Economy, chasing that sweet, sweet virtual dollar, chasing those 200 followers, which we hit and exceeded almost right away on this stream, which is super cool. Thank you all so much for your attention and your eyes and your Twitch follows. We know you have a choice in entertainment. We thank you for sticking it out with me. Yeah, I ended up in Portland, Oregon. We came out of Reno. I'll show you the route real quick since we are on the Pilot Edge network. I have access to PE Aware. Little website made by a extremely good-looking and extremely talented programmer. What's that? Oh, Chris with Aviates. Hello. Thank you for the follow. Appreciate that. So yeah, blasted out off of Reno about about an hour and a half ago, and we are just about to turn onto the final leg of the arrival here into Portland, which basically takes us directly, points us directly at the airport. Some good scenery on the way. Nothing too much to deal with wind or weather-wise, which is great. Oh, practicing some approaches. Excellent. From Bandon to Redmond. Are you from Oregon? I'm from PDX, so... That's why anytime I see an FS Economy leg going into PDX, I'm like, oh yes, I will fly that. You betcha. Alright, 2 minutes to this turn. 22 Whiskey, hello. Good evening. I think I've seen you on some of the other Flight Sims Dreams, maybe some of the other GSA folks.
And 41 contact NorCal.
Thanks for the follow, appreciate it. You're in Redmond, but your flight school's in Bend. That's awesome, man. That's great. I was hoping to get out to Bend end of February for a developer conference. Disgrace Pilot, thank you for the host, appreciate that. Hoping to get out to Bend and do some hobnobbing with my fellow developers, but I don't know if that conference is going to happen. They're taking their sweet time announcing it, and if it's it's supposed to be in less than a month, I don't think it's happening, which is too bad. Love visiting Bend. Love getting out there.
And 41 NorCal Pacific, cleared ILS and runway 28.
All right. We got 1 minute to go. It's going to get very exciting, extremely exciting stuff here on the Tempe Twitch. We're going to start our descent and hit advance at 10K. That's it. Disgrace Pilot, thank you for the pilot. Haven't seen me streaming in a long time. Yes, that's true. Alertly noticed. I took 2 years off streaming. I streamed a bunch in January 2015, got 3 or 4 videos up, and then kids got older and we're in kind of a critical phase of child rearing where they needed more time, and then we decided to sell our house and move a couple miles. So the good news is I went from the garage to a home office, which is much nicer for streaming. Lets me have an actual setup that's nice. I don't have a furnace in my ear at all times, so that's good. But it did mean taking a couple of years off the simming hobby and didn't really have a PC set up there for the couple of years. So it's great to be back. Loving it. Have I tried the GTN 750? I have not. I hear great things about it, but I have not heard it. All right, let's make that turn. Go plane, go. Yeah, buddy. All right, let's go down. First we close the GPS. Second, pressurization. We are landing it pretty close to sea level. Set that. And let's head on down to 10,000. It's great, except you can't use it without the payware. Yeah, I hate stuff like that. I also hate, speaking of things that I hate, this manipulator. You have to get like right up on it to find the area that turns it into the hand icon. There we go. That lets you pull it. Pretty annoying. Alright. Pull the power back here. Keep an eye on that. Make sure we don't overspeed on the way down. That would not be good. And keep an eye on our rate of descent as well. I think we're going to need to speed up just a little bit. So we got 5 minutes to portal. Oh no. There we go. Whew. We're attacking. Yeah. 5 minutes to portal, probably another 5 minutes to advance. So we got 10 minutes to drop 12,000, which means we need about 1,200 PM. So we'll go 13 and call her good. Now we just got to watch the speed, make sure we don't blow through the 250 speed limit. Are we? Okay, Corvallis. Yeah, so we're south of Portland, about an hour's drive. Coming through this overcast. Check the weather one more time. Alright. Oh! Oh my. Latest METAR is winds 120 at 7, visibility 10, but an overcast at 1,500. So. that broken that was hanging out down low firmed up on us. So we're definitely shooting the ILS, and we good. Some of my charts here. Minimums on the ILS to get us down to 260, so we should have plenty of chances to should have plenty of time to get in and find a runway. But yeah, exciting. Once we get handed off to Portland Approach, I'll make our approach request. I could ask him now because he's probably going to be the same controller for both positions, but in the real world, Seattle Center would not be too interested in your approach requests into Portland, so we'll hold off for now. Coming through 18,000. Barometer set. Turn our landing light on, because why not? Cabin is descending. Yes, it is. Perfect. Look at me. I sound like such an expert on this plane's pressurization systems that I just learned how to use an hour ago, thanks to fortuitously having the wise Steve Kirks in my Twitch chat, and he explained to me how it worked. And another guy, Arizona Flyer. But now I'm like, oh yes, we must make sure the cabin is descending. I know exactly what I'm doing.
Delta 286, just in the past, express and maintain level 240.
Portal in 2 minutes. Yeah. Should be good, vertically speaking. I guess I could have used the VNAV planning. I never use this because I'm used to flying planes that just have the 430, which doesn't have the VNAV button. That would have been, like, the smart thing to do. We just decided to wing it.
Reckon T50 plus on to Sierra approved.
About to come down through this layer here. Speed's looking good. We're definitely going fast. We could descend slower if we wanted to. But I like to go fast. So, it's fine. One thing I don't know how to set is the decision height. Maybe we can find that while we have some time on our hands. Decision. Silencer. No. Usually it's a knob around here somewhere. Volumes. Trims. Temperature. Cabin pressure. I have no idea. I'm sure it's around here somewhere. Someone knows where it is. Give a shout, otherwise we will just have to pay attention.
Yeah, 41 contact San Francisco Tower, 120.5.
Oh, that's where that guy was going. San Francisco also has a 2A left. All right, that makes sense. Now.
Yeah, 41 San Francisco Tower, runway 28 left, clear to land, wind calm.
4 minutes, 30 seconds to drop 4,200 feet at 1,300 feet per minute. That will work just fine. No
American
problem.
American 250 Phoenix Ground, runway 8, taxi via Sierra Bravo.
that worked out pretty well, descent planning wise. I wanted to descend super early and slow ourselves down for no good reason. But the last thing you want to do is be trying to dive bomb. It does not make good for a very stable approach, so. The approach frequency here. I asked for this approach. Should work. Winds are right for it, as far as I can tell. And like I said, it just makes for a shorter taxi. The runway's a little bit shorter. 9,800 feet instead of 11,000. This is a PC-12, so that will be fine. That will be more than enough. That will be enough that I should be able to land this thing pretty softly, he said. Cut through this layer here that X-Enviro is so beautifully drawing for us. Best money I've ever spent on flight sim, buying X-Enviro. If you're an X-Plane pilot and you do not have X-Enviro, stop whatever you're saving for. Do not buy another plane. Do not buy another add-on. Get yourself X-Enviro as soon as you can. Or come to the day in the live stream that I'll be doing, February 11th. How's that for a transition? Because I will be giving away a copy of X-Enviro. It's one of the giveaways I have. So you can pay for it, or you can just show up and win it. Either way, get yourself a copy. It's sweet. This is cool. I just love this, like, transitioning the layers effect that you get. I don't love the fact that they still kind of pop in. Now and again, that's like my least favorite thing about X-Plane weather is flying along and boom, suddenly you have no visibility. Cool. But when it all works, you get really cool effects like this. I'll give it a little more juice here. Gas is fine. We're still barely under 50%. We departed with like 65%, so this thing really sips gas. It does not use hardly any gas at all. It's a great moneymaker for FSE. I'm also going to turn the range on this thing down because holy crap. There we go. Now we're under that layer. Leveling off at 10K.
For 1 Victor Kilo, contact Portland approach 118.42.
1842 for 1 Victor Kilo. Right. Oh, come on. That's pathetic. 18. Seriously?
American 250 Phoenix Tower, runway 8, clear for takeoff, wind 110 at 7.
Portland approach, good evening. Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo with the weather, we'd like ILS 10 left.
Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo, Portland approach, roger, you can expect that.
Alright, we'll expect that, thanks. Right. Easy enough. So, after O City on the map, which, as you can see, is pretty darn close to the airport, right there, and the airport's right up here. We should be given vectors, and in reality, we'll probably be given vectors quite a bit before then, which is great because then we can set up the approach and get things programmed and do that sort of thing. One consequence of flying with the GPS, I can't set the course for the approach until I switch it off GPS mode. So, I suppose I could put it on heading mode, though. Do that. Let's set current heading 3-3. Go to heading mode. Switch back to VLOG on the GPS. Now we can set the approach course, which
United 41 Retro Tech.
The reason I'm so worried about that is that it takes forever on this plane. why they move so oddly. Don't feel like I have this problem with other Carinata planes. But it's not ideal. 103. Alright, there we go. Now we have 111.3, which is the approach frequency right here, with the course of 103, and we are good to go for the approach. Whenever we get vectored, we will fly heading mode and all will be well within the world. I just have to battle the manipulators the whole way down, but it'll be fine. Coming into the metro area here. Our cabin
Delta element. 286, contact Seattle Center 121.4.
Excellent. Carinata has always had click point problems. Yeah, I know. The mouse wheel usually works well for me. But on this plane, like, if I turn the mouse wheel a whole rotation, watch what happens. That was 6 degrees of a whole mouse wheel. So if I wanted to set it to 010 right now,
Delta 286, Seattle Center, descend via the 3 arrival to Portland, altimeter 3023, and proceed free to runway 10 left transition.
I don't know if I'm doing something wrong or if I'm just not understanding how it's supposed to work, but that doesn't feel quite right.
American TV, just about to give us, you're just getting your read back from somebody else, contact departure.
We aren't doing too bad on my ETA. Yeah, the sound is not good.
American 250, Phoenix.
We're not going to be on the ground in 3 minutes. Not even close. But I bet we'll be on the ground in about 13 minutes. We're about 10 minutes off.
Yeah, 3:45 San Francisco.
Considering we have no VNAM or fancy FMS, that's not too bad.
Filed, climb via SID, squawk 6151.
Yeah, the sound is no good. It's really bad. Which is weird because the rest of this plane sounds are actually pretty good. I really like them, like the gear,
yeah, 3:45
extension and retraction. It really hits my sub hard, which it has a very visceral feel.
American 250 negative, delete public speed restrictions.
A lot of the planes I fly that just kind of sounds like me.
41 Victor Kilo, descend and maintain 3,000. Fly heading 330 vectors to final.
330 and down to 3,000 for 41 Victor Kilo. Make first. This is going to take a freaking mile. Come on. Find the magical 2-pixel square area. Connie won't start. Isn't that, like, normal? For an old plane? Sorry. Not sorry. I'm just saying there's a reason they don't fly them anymore. Not because they're ugly, because they're not. It's minus 14 Celsius. Yeah, that might have something to do with it. Could be a factor. Slow down. Like a lot. Like a whole lot. Here we go. I think we just flew over my house. Not too long ago. In case anybody's curious. It ain't leaking, it ain't working. Exactly. Exactly. All right, we're receiving DME.
1 Victor Kilo, contact Portland approach 126.9er.
26.9 for 1 Victor Kilo.
American 250, contact Albuquerque Center 134.32.
Do 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 do. Maybe I just need a more sensitive
probably it.
Brother approach Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo out of 7,100 for 3,000.
Last one. Born Victor Kilo, Portland Park Director. American 250, Op Turkey Center, climb maintain file 320.
It's chugging a little. Don't chug. Just work fine, please. Please. Ooh. 15 frames per second. Could be better. Painful. Alright. Be fine. Everything's fine. Not P3D, so we're not gonna run out of memory. Right? Pretty though. Pretty slideshow.
One Victor Kilo, fly heading 310.
Left 310 for 100 kilo. Oh no. Frames are gone. Oh, this is painful. We're at 1 frame per second right now. It's not CPU, because OBS is doing just fine. Yikes. That is not great. Let's get Xenviro to take a hike. Oh man, 1.1. This is not good. I have many skills. Flying a plane at 1 frame per second is not among them. Good at all. Let's see. Pause for just a second. See if that does it. No. 1 Victor Kilo will need just a second. Our sim rate went down to 1 frame per second.
Well, after I'm calling fake call sign.
That was 1 Victor Kilo.
1 Victor Kilo, right.
Well, let's try turning this down for the moment. Scenery density. Yeah. Let's just turn everything down. I'd like to land this flight if we can. Just turn everything down to default for a little bit. Do-do. I have flown out of Portland many times in this with these settings and never had this problem, so can't say I know what would take make it go from a barely there but tolerable 19 down to 1 all of a sudden like that. That was weird. I've not seen that before, but we'll crank the settings way down and see if that gets us going again. It's climbing now. 1.2, 1.5. Oh man. Can I turn Xenviro off? Yeah. Now the sim looks like garbage. Oh no. Climbing. Still climbing. Can I use these manipulators, like, at all? Not really. We're up to 3 frames per second. Better than 1. I can move the heading bug. sort of. NVIDIA card. I do have an NVIDIA card. And
Delta 286,
I think
contact
I do have threaded optimization on. Because I've never had a problem with it before now. Until this precise moment. Now the question is, can I turn it off without restarting the app? My guess is no. Yeah, set to auto.
Delta 286, Portland approach, expect the ILS runway 10 left approach.
We're,
Portland
we're playing
also
with fire
3023.
Here. Playing with serious fire. By changing graphic card settings, but my guess is. Yeah. My guess is that this would take an X-plane restart. Yeah, issues where you take FPS tanks in flight, that's certainly what happened. So, let's do this. Approach 1, Victor Kilo. We're going to try disconnecting and reconnecting real quick. About 3 minutes. Let's try saving the situation. Let's see if we can come back after restarting this app. Well, wait a minute. No, 5 FPS. Yeah, no issue with threaded optimization, I know. I've heard of this, I just haven't encountered it firsthand. Boy, we just took a dive. All right, let's quit explain.
G35, left, text via alpha map.
I don't know if reloading the situation like I just tried to do will work. We're gonna see what we can do here. Because man, that was brutal. All right, threaded optimization is off globally. Let's go check it for X-plane. Sorry, thought we were in good shape there. Not scanning. Okay, X-plane. Threaded optimization is off. Great. Reload here. Just need to turn off our X-plane. Yeah, I know. I'll go back and fix that later. I just wanted to make sure it was off for reals. Let's see if I can reload that situation of where I was. Oh, poop. I just realized X economy probably dumped us off too. Let's see what happened. Oh, it still says airborne. Not good. That means it's probably going to put the plane back to Reno. Dang it. Oh well. We failed at our quest for the virtual dollar. Foiled by NVIDIA. I'll send them an invoice. All right, we're back. We have 41 frames per second. Life is good. Can we load the situation? Whoa. All right. That appears to have worked perfectly. Holy cow. I'm sort of impressed that that worked. All right, we are paused. I'm going to reconnect Pilot Edge.
3.55, good day.
There we go. Portland Approach 1, Victor Kilo, how do you hear? Rob, thank you so much for the follow. Appreciate that. Portland Approach, Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo, you with us?
Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo, affirmative.
Alright, sorry about that. We had to do a sim restart, but we are back and turning to left to 310 now.
1 Victor Kilo, red.
Back to our frames. That's good. Unfortunately, now the approach will be ugly because I turned my settings all down. That's unfortunate. But I'm actually sort of amazed that worked. We saved a situation and reloaded it, and the plane came totally back. And like, I don't know. I may regret saying this now. Like, the lights are off. Gens are fine. Yeah, a couple things are wrong, like the cooling system.
Cancel takeoff, cancel my one left, light up and wait, let me know when you're ready to go.
Probes got turned off somehow. Oh, too much light. Way too much. We're not getting blown around like crazy. Woof. Invisible because of weather, but that's fine.
Yeah, 345, no problem. We one left bit for takeoff.
Position wise, we should be getting the turn, some more turns here fairly soon. Yeah, that was exciting. I think that was threaded optimization, though. I think that's exactly what that was. Because I've read when it hits hard, and that's precisely what happened. We were cruising along at 19 FPS, and then bam. Down to one. So if you're watching this and you have an NVIDIA card, go turn threaded optimization off. Don't be like me. Don't think your system is impervious.
Altitude 6, contact port.
Because it's not.
26 might matter.
I'll turn the controller up just a scooch. Done that before, but it got lost.
Portland Approach, Delta 286 with you, Adam 9.9.
All right, localizer is alive.
Lights are left, ILS. Yeah,
great.
Delta 286, Portland Approach, Roger.
Who's this Delta coming in? Is this someone on the stream, by chance? Anyone watching? Say hello, if so. So I'll call him back and make sure we're working.
One Victor Kilo, 5 miles from trail, fly heading 070, maintain 3 dots until established on the localizer. Clear ILS runway 10 left approach.
070 and 3000 until established for one Victor Kilo.
Delta 286, fly heading to 270, and then maintain 3,000 vectors to final.
Right. Approach on, and let's slow way down.
Yeah, 345, contact departure.
So, sorry about the
286,
suboptimal sim settings here.
Vectors are final.
I suppose I could have put them back before we what were you doing here? But I wanted to make sure that wasn't the actual problem too. So that was part of my thinking there. All right, let's go flaps 15. Rob KBTL and I have been friends, I want to guess, for about 10 years in Flight Sim. We used to do FS Economy together way back. It's good to see you again, Rob. It's been a while. Let's go flaps 30. Super crazy. All right, 10 miles. Airport's gonna be over here-ish. See a little part of it, maybe not. Glide slope starting to come down. Slow but sure. Lights. Landing light is on. Stroke beacon nav. Pick up on for approach. We're good with flaps 30, I think, for the landing, since it's a nice long runway. Flight idle for condition. There's the interception. Let's go ahead and drop the wheels.
Victor Kilo, contact Portland Tower 118.7.
18.7 for 1 Victor Kilo. Glide slope is active. Portland Tower, good evening. Pilatus 1 Victor Kilo is on the ILS 10 left.
1 Victor Kilo, Portland Tower, wind 110 at 7, runway 10 left, clear to land.
110 at 7 and 10 left, clear to land for 1 Victor Kilo. There's that traffic. Nice. Is that Delta? Probably. Sweet. What's our warning? Stage trim up. We gotta speed up. We gotta speed up fast. Let's go. There we go. Try and find a good power setting here that works for this. Decision height 293 or 263 on the radar. That we should be good. Assuming X-Plane doesn't eat us an unexpected layer here. X-Plane has already sent us for some loops here, so this is not what my sim is supposed to look like. Just have a lot more going on. But that's okay. Better get on the ground. And don't think about the fact that the FS Economy's flight had to be restarted and we lost it. Just don't think about that. Please. Alright, we got a good landing power now. Should be good. Nice and stable. So we're gonna park right up here. We get down. This is the Mr. X6 PDX. One of the best free sceneries I've ever seen in my life. Little details everywhere. Shopping center over here, you can see the IKEA. he skinned the trains that come into and from the airport so that they're accurate. Like, super cool. Great scenery. And for free. So cool. Alright. 3 miles. Take control.
Delta 286, 3 miles from trail, fly heading 130, maintain 3,000 until stop is on the localizer, clear to ILS on way 10 left approach.
He's right behind us. Pretty good size displaced threshold here.
United 345, contact Oakland Center, 127.45. Yeah, 345, Oakland Center, climb and maintain 50310.
Come on down.
We got rid of that when we swapped to the Western US expansion.
Some of that power.
No, 400.
Screwing this up too badly.
Delta 286, contact Portland Tower 118.7.
300.
We're low. Don't be low. Oof. Bad time for a weather change, X-Plane.
Portland Tower, Delta 286, established.
Turbulence. Left.
Delta 286, Portland Tower number 2, following a Pilatus over the numbers, runway 10 left, clear to land, wind 107.
Number 2 to land.
At this rate, I might not make it there. Clear. Oh man.
Land, Delta 286.
Oh boy.
50. 40. 30.
We're gonna use 20. The extra runway here. Float it on in.
10.
And land right of center quite a bit. But we landed soft. And that was crazy. We're at what? 1 mile out? When all that turbulence kicked in? That was nuts. It was all going so well. Hey Max, good to see you, man. Perfect timing. Didn't feel like using the reversers. Alright. This thing back to ground idle so it doesn't drive like insane. Here, over the line. Kind of want to watch this Delta come in.
Number 1, Victor Kilo, where are you parking today?
We'll be at flight craft, but we'd actually like to hold present position if we can and watch the arrival.
1, Victor Kilo, up if requested.
Alright, thanks. Once we watch this guy, we'll go back and watch my adventure again. Night, Mile High. We'll see you, bud. V Looper, thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. Thanks for sticking with us. We had some adventures on that one. 3,000 feet above ground on the approach is not a great time to have to do a full sim reload, but we learned our lesson. You'll notice, well, you can't see it, but I can. Right now on the ground, frames per second is 55, so I'm almost positive that was the dreaded threaded optimization bug that that bit us there. It was not a overload or a scenery issue or anything like that. So emotes. Yeah, I don't know how Max got himself a custom emote on someone else's stream. That's questionable. All right, Delta. We're watching. Let's screw this up. We're all counting on you. Aircraft is 738. Okay. Looks good. Oh yeah. It's looking real good. Turbulence. Nice. Not bad at all. All right, let's go over to ground and park this boat. Portland Ground, Pilatus 1, Victor Kilo. We'd like to go straight ahead to Flightcraft.
Victor Kilo, taxi to parking UAV, Alpha G'day.
Parking to Alpha G'day. Go park. We'll do some replays real quick. Probably late for some ground stop somewhere. Yeah, probably true. Also hard to sass when we, crazy for iPhone, thanks for the host. Hard to sass when we had such trouble of ours. Around. I don't really care about where we're parking. I'm just gonna park it here.
Portland Tower, Delta 286, clear the active at Alpha 2.
Cut it off and...
Delta 286, taxi to parking via Alpha Victor Kilo. G'day.
Disconnected. And go into replay. All right. We'll take it about here. That's good. Let's see. Beacon? That's pretty close. No. I don't know what runway this is. It is not the one we were going for. Fine, we'll do it this way. There we go. Alright. Play. Oh, my cinematography is not so good. Go over here. It's free cam. About where the turbulence started, I think. Yeah, floated it pretty hard there. Oh well. All things considered, considering how much turbulence came up on short final, I'm not too sad about it. Just one more time from the passenger perspective here.
Forty. Thirty. 20.
10. Say 10. Yeah. Not the best, but I was pretty rattled from the sim having to restart, so that's my excuse. Alright, that's all I got for tonight. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. Thanks for hanging out in chat. It was a lot of fun keeping up with everyone and seeing what everyone was talking about. So we'll see you again soon.